Aloha. So I am in another aircraft now. I'm in a Cessna Skymaster. And I am trying to figure this aircraft out. I've never flown it before. Had it for quite a while, just never flown it. Had a lot of issues with getting the cockpit level. This is an aircraft that when you start, it starts at an angle. So it's it's a kind of a we barely made it up. Right. So flaps up, gear up. And we are still climbing. Now, one quirk here is my nav plan. I'm not seeing it. Maybe from Seattle it'll be. now, and if you wonder why I'm doing all this dialing, I turned autopilot on, but it came up at 99,000 feet. Obviously, that's not where I'm headed. So I'm trying to dial it down to 4,000 feet. So there's 4,000 feet. And there. And then we'll go with heading. And heading, I want heading to go to 109. Alright. So getting it to play on altitude. So doesn't seem like autopilot wants to play. And I am off course because I have paid far too much attention to my autopilot. So looks like I'm getting there on my own. As always, trimming these aircraft is such a pain. Alright. And he just won't let me trim it. Pretty close to our altitude. And we're coming up on a turn. Airport over there on the left. Very quick flight. I'm a little disappointed I didn't have autopilot, and you saw how a little disjointed I was, kind of getting resettled into manually piloting the aircraft. I've been spoiled by that autopilot on my Cessna 172. Very spoiled. But now we're flying a good heading, and we're at 2700 coming down to 1900. Island on the left. That's Gardner's Island up there. I think that's Fisher's Island up there. Almost on altitude. Feet. I spoiled myself. All right, after this, our next heading is 048. To the right of our intended track, so we're gonna correct for that. We're getting there. We are getting there. I guess it's a pretty interesting aircraft to fly, and I am fairly impressed that Air Manager so far is doing good things for me. Everything's kind of working in the cockpit. you're in transition. Gear down and locked. Landing flap set. I'm just a little off, but I keep kind of grabbing in. Could just be me. But we'll correct for it and we'll... There we go. All right. And we're down. Whoa! I did nothing there. I don't know what just happened. Ooh. A little bit of fun right there. Well, wasn't that mighty helpful? Just taxi to some random parking spot? Didn't actually tell me where. How awesome was that, right? I kind of... There's parking there, but I think that's air services kind of stuff. And here's where I'm really glad I have an electronic flight bag, sort of, kind of, because it allows me to figure out where some of this stuff is. So we'll take this right. And this should, yeah, there's two different groups of aviation parking over here. We'll pass the first one, we'll get to the second one. So we're passing number one. And we're gonna take our next right hand turn. And let's park over here somewhere. Whoa! I was just gonna drive over to there, but did not realize that was just grass. So let's find one of these spots up here. Because at this airport, there really are spots up here. So, yeah, we'll park right here. And we'll set the parking brake and we're done. Woo! Not bad for my first flight with this aircraft though. Gotta say that was a fun aircraft to fly now that I've got it all configured. I'm a fan. So that was a Cessna Skymaster. So let me turn this light on here. So that was the Cessna Skymaster. And we'll hit continue real quick. And that way we'll just go to the external view. And yeah, there's the Cessna Skymaster. You can kind of see it right there. And cockpit wise, these are the Air Master panels. This is an Air Master panel, and this is the other Air Master panel. I based them both off of that actual aircraft's panel. They did work really well for me. Now, the quirky thing for me was, and it was just getting used to that aircraft, in the cockpit there, the fuel valves, and again, this is just me getting used to the aircraft, are in the overhead. So they're here, the fuel selectors. So it was a little quirky to just figure out where my fuel selectors were. But once I did that, I was fine. Life was good. And the other quirky thing for me, and it's been on this aircraft forever, is when you start this aircraft up, you're at an angle. So I have to use the right mouse button and the trackball at the same time to zero out the aircraft so it's flyable. Other than that, it was a fun aircraft to fly. You saw the quirks at the end, but it's probably just me getting used to this plane. I am a fan of it. And again, the generic nature of this cockpit was kind of great for that. I'm pretty happy about that. So any questions, comments, concerns, by all means, ask away. The only thing on this flight for me that was quirky was the autopilot. That was an entirely manual flight. So, you saw me getting a little confused there, or a little, I'll say, discombobulated, because I was expecting to use autopilot and not so much. Had I been prepared for it, it might have been a little better. But I'm still going to throw this video up at some point. So thanks for watching. And I got to say, setting this up for a generic cockpit is kind of a win. At least I think it is. So stay safe and happy flying out there.